all of those out. Okay, so you get four x cubed minus 72 x squared plus 308 x. It's going to be your equation for the volume of the box that you can create from this piece of cardboard. Now, does that work for any x? Like, what would be the domain of this function? All real positive numbers?
No, it had to be less than...
Can we put in, could x be 50 inches?
No, it had to be less than like half 14, because eventually you'll get to where you're just folding the paper in half, and that's it.
Okay, so it's going to have to be half of 14 or less, because if x is 10, you're going to run out of cardboard, right? So the range is, it obviously can't be 0.
Is this the main or is this range?
Well, this is the this would be the domain, right? Yeah. This would be your input. Yeah. So you can write it like that, or you can... Are there any questions how we got from here to here? Does this make sense to everybody?
You have a question 13 in there now.
Same section?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, number 13 says we want to consider the point x, y. It's lying on the graph of the line 2x plus 4y equals 5. Okay, and we want to consider any point xy that lies on it. Let L be the distance. L equals distance. Between from xy to the origin. And we want to write L as a function of x. Any idea how to get this one started?
Use the distance formula from xy to the origin.
Okay, what's the distance formula?
It would be 0 minus y over 0 minus x. No, I just do.
Anybody know the distance formula? X2 and X1. And Y2 and Y1. Do you know any of those? we need to, we need to do something with it first. Okay, let's take this and set it equal to y. Okay. Do that over here. Questions on how I got to there? Be pretty basic. So we're gonna take this here and plug it in for our y.
Square root
x squared
plus negative 1/2 x plus 5/4 all of that squared.
This is a function of x. Let's go ahead and see if we can simplify it. So we multiply this out. But as far as simplifying goes, I mean, I think you should be able to get from here to a more simpler function of x, right? Just multiply that out, add the x squares together. Close enough. All right, any more from section 1-1? If not, then we can move on to section 1-2. Functions, composites of functions. Any questions over those? complete this table. This is composite of functions. Okay. This column is all g of x. This column is all f of x. And this, the third column is f of g of x. Okay? So if this is f of x and this is g of x, how do we find f of g of x? Okay, we want to put g of x into as the input into f of x. So it would be f of x minus 7. This would be our f of g of x. Okay, what about this one? What does f of g of x then? What? Okay. Now if we're given f of g of x and f of x, how can we get g of x? Minus 5 to equal, so we have to, something we had to plug in there to get, make it that. So, what'd you say, Jacob?
X squared.
X squared.
So, it's a mathematical way to do that. Because it's not always going to be where we look at it and find out. Would we, is it like, you know what I mean?
I know what you're asking. Some of these, well, at least these here I can just look at. Is there a mathematical way to get there?
More than likely.
It won't give you, the ones that you can.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay, what about this one? Everything. We want this. And for every x we see, we're going to put this in for. Simplify that. Common denominator. What's our common denominator? X minus 1. This would stay x minus, what would this be? Okay. X minus x. Just be 1 over x minus 1. What's that simplify?